So tell me, what prompted you to re-release and re-record Amazing Grace?
We listened in New York to a recording that was played in the streets of London by a preacher named Pat Atherton. He went to the hospital, a Charing Cross hospital, and played my version of Amazing Grace outside the hospital. And it had 5 million media hits. And it got our attention. And we looked at it and said, this is exactly what we need to have singing so that it will help people to get through this pandemic. And I just thought, well, it's a perfect thing to do. And my record company agreed. And so they put this amazing, remarkable, viral choir together of people all over the world singing behind me on the chorus of my original vocal. And by the way, I can still sing it in that key.
Wow.
Of course you can, Judy. It's just so beautiful. It's iconic. We'd like to look at some of that glorious re-release of the global virtual quality. Let's see that. That is sensational. I don't even understand, Judy, how you can make a virtual choir to create even more beauty than you originally did. How big a healing do you think this can be for not only your country, but the world?
People have told me here in this country, in this pandemic, because we're all in lockdown. I'm at home here in lockdown like everybody is. But I think we really need it. And a lot of people have called me and said, you know, I just play Amazing Grace at night before I go to sleep because it's the only way I can go to sleep. So I don't think there's any doubt that it helps to all the health workers and the people who are in very upsetting, dangerous situations. And I have always found that Amazing Grace does a lot for me. It's gotten me through terrible things in my life. And it's been, you know, a part of many, many sad celebrations that are sad funerals and memorials that I've been to, that I've sung at. I've sung to probably more memorials than I would like to even remember. But during this time, I think it's uplifting to hear the song and to hear the voices and to realize that we're all in this together.
I think you're absolutely right. And the bonus from that is that the proceeds from the sale of the re-release are going to the World Health Organization's Solidarity Response Fund. Why did you want the money to go there?
Well, I wanted to help in the most global way that we could figure out. And everybody who was involved with this put their heads together and said, well, we'd like to see the money go to WHO, to World Health, because they've done so much and they're doing so much. And with their help, we'll also get through this internationally. It's not just one country, it's everybody. It's not just one group somewhere, it's all of us. And the World Health always has represented that. They work for the planet, not just for the single person.
Yes, and Judy, who thought we'd ever be going through a pandemic in our lifetimes? But are you still performing? Because we did find one of your performances last year. Are you still performing?
110 shows a year.
Wow.
All over the country and the world. You know, my team has been trying to get me off the road for 2 months in the summer for about 3 or 4 decades, and they've never been able to do it. And so now here we are, and here I am. And of course, yes, I'm practicing, I'm writing, I'm trying to write poetry, I'm trying to get my new album together. And I'm singing with how many? Hundreds and hundreds of people around the country singing Amazing Grace. So I've never stopped working. I think it's not just in the blood and the DNA, but it's also what I do for my own mental health. And I don't think it only helps other people. I think it helps me.
Well, let's face it, Judy, look, neither of us are spring chickens, but to be able to do that at any age, let alone your fabulous years, I've just got to say, is there a secret?
There's a secret. I think the secret is that I work at it. I exercise, I eat well, I meditate, I try to practice every day. I watch a lot of movies. We are watching a lot of movies and having a wonderful time doing it. My husband and I, you know, he has me cooking for him twice a day. I don't do his breakfast. I let him handle that.
And if you would like to get your version of Amazing Grace, head to judycollins.com for more. Judy, thank you so much for joining us today.
Oh, you're so welcome. Amazing Grace. That's it.
Beautiful.